Welcome, this is Ruben for Sonokinetic, and this is the tutorial video for Capriccio in detail. If you haven't already, please watch the overview video first to get a general impression of what Capriccio is all about. This video is much longer and much more in detail, and here I'll be going into all the functions and operations of Capriccio. The first thing to know is that Capriccio is a phrase-based library where the phrases sync to the tempo of your host DAW. Everything has been recorded in 4/4 meter at 130 BPM, but the phrases will be time-stretched automatically to fit your project. So first, let's look at loading phrases and getting them to play. I'll be demonstrating this with the strings patch, but the techniques I'll show you are exactly the same for woods, brass, and both pitched and orchestral percussion. The runs and multi-sample percussion patches operate similarly, but they do have some unique functions, so we've recorded a separate tutorial video for each of those. Each instance of Capriccio has space to load 12 phrases in total, and these are divided over 4 presets, 1, 2, 3, 4. Each one of these presets has 3 phrases each, 1, 2, 3, and as you saw there, you can change between presets by either clicking the tabs or via the key switches, just here. In the case of strings, the keys are C3, C-sharp 3, D3 and D-sharp 3, but the preset key switches are different for every patch of Capriccio. You can see exactly which keys trigger which patches with the helpful info overlay here. So strings, woodwinds, brass, pitch percussion, percussion and the runs. And this is the same story for muting and unmuting individual fields. Again, you can click. All the key switches are just here for the strings. They're in different places for the other instruments. The Capriccio manual has a list of all the key switches too, and the mutes are velocity sensitive. You press with a high velocity to unmute and low velocity to mute. Because the different Capriccio instruments all have different key switches for presets and mutes, it means that you could load them all into one instance of contact and change presets and mute and unmute on the fly, which is very handy. So let's play Capriccio. Here we have 3 different string phrases loaded in 3 fields, and as long as they're not muted, the phrases will all play simultaneously when you play a triad, major or minor chord on the blue keys here. Inversions are also recognised. You heard 3 phrases playing together there. These phrases can be changed by just clicking the phrase graphic, and this opens the phrase picker for you to select a different phrase. You can preview the phrases by clicking the speaker next to the graphic. It's worth mentioning that these previews won't play all the phrases available, just the first variation so you get an idea. You can also see here if the phrase has a different major and minor version, in this case here, or if it's mapped to a parallel minor, in this case here. If there's nothing indicated, then the phrase is gender neutral, so it doesn't have to change between major and minor. It's not really something you have to think about, as all phrases sound great in major or minor, but the information is there if you want it. The strings, woodwinds, brass and orchestral percussion all have high, mid and low phrases. The pitched percussion is a little different and splits the phrases into piano, wood and iron instruments. There's no reason you have to have high, mid and low. In fact, you can load any phrase into any field. Often, more than one phrase can be represented by the same graphic, so you can choose variations by clicking the small button here. If you need inspiration, you can randomise the phrases by clicking the O of Capriccio in any patch. If you're not using a particular preset, then you've got the option to purge the samples to save RAM. Just click here. Click again to reload. It's worth noting that a particular phrase won't be purged if it's used in another field in the same instance of contact. In the bottom right corner of each field, you can find the harmonic shift button, which you can turn on in one or more fields, and this shifts the relative key of that field, using these key switches just here. There's a dedicated harmonic shift video if you want to know more about that. This is the control for mod wheel volume, which can be turned on and off by clicking. And this enables you to control the volume of any field with the mod wheel of your keyboard. Useful for changing volumes of some fields without affecting the others. Here you can change the field speed relative to your host tempo. Either original speed, double speed, half speed, or the default option, which is intelligent tempo mapping. And this will determine the most realistic and useful tempo relative to your DAW's host tempo. Changing the speed like this will sound better with some phrases than others, also depending on the bass tempo of your composition. For any phrase, you can open the score view, which will show you exactly which instruments are being used and what they're playing. Click on the virtual keyboard to change keys, and you can see major and minor variations, if they vary for the phrase. The PDF score is also available for purchase on the Sonokinetic website, and obviously the percussion score is the same for all keys. Brand new to Capriccio is the drag MIDI feature, enabling you to literally drag the MIDI from this score into your DAW. We've covered that in more detail in a separate video. So that's it for the individual field controls. Now let's look at the global controls. Click here to open them. The first control is for volume level for each field, and this can be adjusted just by dragging up and down. You can also command or control click to reset the volumes to default. New to Capriccio, it's now possible to set different levels for the release tails. Just click the graphic here, and this will allow you to adjust the release level samples, just by dragging the end part of the overlay here. So for example, you can click the graphic a second time to lock the release note volume level back to the main phrase level. Each field has a panning control. Again, drag left and right to change that, and you can command click to center it. Let's look at woodwinds for the next couple of global settings. Here you can change the crossfade times when one chord or phrase transitions to another. I'll cover this control in a bit more detail in the tempo syncing video, but as a rule of thumb for fast phrases, you should set the crossfade time quite fast. For longer legato phrases, like this one, you should be a bit more generous with the crossfade time. And this will create a smoother transition. Next is the new sample offset control. This enables you to change the sample start position of any fields relative to the others. Just drag the button left or right to change the sample start point, and each dash represents a 16th note. So far left will play one beat ahead and far right will play one beat behind. You can use this function in two ways. Firstly, small adjustments can help just to tighten up the timing of the phrases relative to one another. Secondly, larger offsets can create polyrhythms and syncopation, which adds another level of creativity. Let me give you another example of that using the pitched percussion patch. So this phrase here is just a single piano note, and it plays on beat one. And when we move the offset slider all the way to the right, you'll hear how that changes. And left. Next up, I'll use brass to explain how the microphone positions work. We've captured four microphone positions: decatree, close, wide, and far. And you can choose just one or a mix of the two by setting them left and right of the slider here. The slider mixes between two different positions. You can save CPU and RAM by just choosing one mic position and setting the other one to none. Or alternatively, we've provided a set of pre-mix patches called Capriccio Lite if your system is struggling with the full range of mic positions. There's a global tuning option, so you can set Capriccio to a standard pitch of 440Hz, or a little higher, to a number of concert pitches. This is especially useful if you're mixing Capriccio with live recordings. And the last option is the harmonic shift matrix, which I'm not going to cover here as it has its own video tutorial. I'm just going to look at percussion briefly, and you'll notice that the graphics here are a little different to represent the percussive nature of the phrases. The high, mid and low division in the percussion patch not so much represents tonal range as it does the note density of the patterns. In the high fields you'll find shorter note values and generally more notes, and in low you'll find more sparse patterns. There's also no harmonic shift function as percussion is atonal. So that's a good look at Capriccio in detail. For more information, please take a look at the manual, check out our other videos, or head to the Sonokinetic website at www.sonokinetic.net. And thanks so much for watching. Bye-bye.